In this lesson, we will begin discussing pipe networks by applying the conservation of mass and conservation of energy equations to systems that have pipes in series, pipes in parallel, and pipes that split or branch. This will result in some useful expressions and concepts that can be used to analyze complicated pipe networks. When analyzing pipe networks, we often make the following assumptions. First, we assume the flow is steady. This means the flow characteristics in the pipe network do not change significantly in time. The second assumption is the flow is isothermal, resulting in the viscosity being constant throughout the pipe network. This is a reasonable assumption for many pipe networks where the fluid temperature doesn't change greatly, such as a municipal water supply. The third assumption is the flow is incompressible, resulting in the density being constant throughout the pipe network. This is a good assumption for the flow speeds and pressures typically encountered in many pipe networks. We first examine pipes in series. Here we have three pipes with three different diameters, D1, D2, and D3. The flow enters at point A on the left and exits at point B on the right. Since the flow is steady through the pipes, the mass flow rate from A to B, which is denoted as m.ab, is the same throughout the three pipes. That is, m.ab is equal to m.1, is equal to m.2, and equal to m.3. Since the mass flow rate is equal to the density rho times the volumetric flow rate q, and the density is constant, this means the volumetric flow rate is constant throughout the three pipes as well. And we will call this flow rate QAB. So QAB is equal to Q1 and equal to Q2 and equal to Q3. From now on, we will usually use volumetric flow rates rather than mass flow rates when using conservation of mass. The volumetric flow rate is equal to the flow speed V times the cross-sectional area A. And since the pipe diameter changes, the speed changes as well to maintain a constant volumetric flow rate. Now let's apply the conservation of energy equation from point A to point B. We draw a control volume around the three pipes, denoted by the red dashed line, with an inlet at A and an outlet at B. The conservation of energy equation is the pressure head plus velocity head plus elevation head at outlet B is equal to the pressure head plus velocity head plus elevation head at inlet A minus the head loss from the inlet to the outlet, HLAB, plus the pump head minus the turbine head. Since the flow must travel through all three pipes, the total head loss is simply the sum of the head loss through each of the three pipes, HL1 plus HL2 plus HL3. Now let's look at a system where the flow can travel through pipes in parallel. Here we have two water reservoirs connected by two pipes. The reservoir on the left has a free surface at point A, and the reservoir on the right has a free surface at point B. We will assume the elevation difference, ZA minus ZB, is known. Since free surface A is at a higher elevation compared to free surface B, water will flow from the left reservoir to the right reservoir through the two pipes. A volumetric flow rate, Q1, flows through pipe 1, and a volumetric flow rate, Q2, flows through pipe 2. The total volumetric flow rate from reservoir A to reservoir B, QAB, is the sum of the flow rates through both pipes, Q1 plus Q2. If the pipe diameters D1 and D2 are different, the speeds V1 and V2 and flow rates Q1 and Q2 will differ. Now we will determine the relationship between the head loss in pipe 1 and the head loss in pipe 2. We assume the reservoirs are so large that the elevation doesn't change significantly over the time period we observe them. Since a constant head is applied at the inlet and outlet of each pipe, this means the flow through each pipe is constant in time. This also means that the flow through each pipe is independent, and we can plug up pipe 2 without it impacting the flow through pipe 1. Now that the flow through pipe 1 is isolated, we draw a control volume with an inlet at free surface A and an outlet at free surface B. The conservation of energy equation is the pressure head plus velocity head plus elevation head at B equals the pressure head plus velocity head plus elevation head at A minus the head loss related to the flow through pipe 1, HL1, plus the pump head minus the turbine head. The pressure difference between free surface A and free surface B is usually negligible compared to the other terms in the equation, so we eliminate the pressure heads. Since points A and B are at the top of the reservoirs and the water level does not change significantly in time, the speed at those points is 0, which means the velocity head terms are 0 too. The pump head and turbine head are 0 because no pumps or turbines exist in the control volume. Rearranging the remaining terms gives us the difference in elevation heads, ZA minus ZB, is equal to the head loss, HL1. This means the head loss through pipe 1 is only related to the difference in elevation of the free surfaces, which is constant. Now notice our decision to plug up pipe 2 was arbitrary. If we plugged up pipe 1 and analyzed the flow through pipe 2 instead, we would find that ZA minus ZB is equal to HL2. So for a parallel pipe configuration, the head losses through the pipes are equal. The last system that we'll examine has pipes that branch or split at a node N. We'll keep the same reservoirs A and B, but connect them with a different set of pipes. Reservoir A is connected to pipe 1, and the entire flow, Q1, must travel through this pipe to node N. At the node, the flow can travel through pipe 2 or pipe 3 to enter reservoir B. The flow rate through pipe 2 is Q2, and the flow rate through pipe 3 is Q3. Since the entire flow from reservoir A to reservoir B must travel through pipe 1, and then the entire flow must travel through either pipe 2 or pipe 3, the total volumetric flow rate, QAB, is equal to Q1, which is also equal to the sum of Q2 plus Q3. If we isolate the node with a control volume, we see that the water flows into the control volume from pipe 1 and flows out of the control volume through pipe 2 and pipe 3. There's one inlet and two outlets for this control volume. We can generalize the conservation of mass equation for a case where there may be multiple inlets and outlets. The sum of all volumetric flow rates into a node is equal to the sum of all volumetric flow rates out of a node, where here we have replaced the pipe number with the index J. Now we will determine the relationship between the head losses in the branching pipes. We draw a control volume for the fluid that travels through pipe 1 and the top branch, pipe 2. The inlet of the control volume is at free surface A and the outlet is at free surface B. The conservation of energy equation is the pressure head plus velocity head plus elevation head at B equals the pressure head plus velocity head plus the elevation head at A minus the head loss from A to B plus the pump head minus the turbine head. The pressure difference between free surface A and B is usually negligible compared to the other terms, so we can neglect the difference in pressure heads. The velocity at free surface A and free surface B are 0, so the velocity head terms are 0 as well. The pump and turbine heads are 0 because no pumps or turbines exist in the control volume. Rearranging the remaining terms gives us the difference in elevation between the tops of the reservoirs, ZA minus ZB, equals the total head loss from A to B. Since pipes 1 and 2 are in series, the total head loss from A to B is simply the head loss in pipe 1 plus the head loss in pipe 2. If instead we drew a control volume for the fluid that travels through pipe 1 and the bottom branch, pipe 3, the resulting expression would be similar. We would find that ZA minus ZB is equal to the head loss in pipe 1 plus the head loss in pipe 3. Comparing these two equations, the head losses in the two branches are equal.